Hello guys, this is Revans from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 28. PUBG's developer Krafton invests ₹164 crores in India's esports company Nodwin Gaming. Nazara will continue to own over 50% stake in Nodwin Gaming, with the remaining being held by Jet Synthesis and Nodwin founders. It will help to provide the better gaming infrastructure and technology. Apple is expected to start manufacturing the iPhone 12 in India. These phones are expected to be manufactured at the Foxconn facility in Tamil Nadu. It looks like the company is planning to move about 7-10% of its production to India. Apple's Spring event is going to take place on March 23rd, and it is going to unveil the rumored 8TX 2021 iPad Pro models and AirPods 3 and a new Apple TV streaming box. Apple partnership with TSMC for more efficient chips that allowed multiple breakthroughs when it comes to silicon development. Firstly, we have 5-nanometer SoCs running on smartphones, notebooks, even if the M1 Max also use them. Phone makers using 3-nanometer chips will become the most commonplace, and shortly after 2-nanometer parts. TSMC already developed and secured the 2-nanometer chip orders. Asus is gearing up for the ROG Phone 5 launch. The company will unveil its upcoming gaming smartphone on March 10th. The flagship smartphone is confirmed to feature a Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 processor. Asus TUF-15 gaming laptop with 11th generation Intel CPU launched in India. It gonna come with Intel Core H-series processor. The laptop get display options up to 250Hz refresh rate. Asus TUF-15 price in India starts at ₹1,39,999. Jio Business has introduced an integrated offering for micro, small and medium businesses founded on three key pillars. First is an enterprise-grade fiber connectivity that offers voice and data services. Second being digital solutions that will help enterprises manage and grow their business. While the third being the devices that enables the leading digital solutions for MSMBs. Please check on the screen for the Jio Business tariff table. Paytm transforms Android phones into card payment machines, and shoppers would love the convenience. You simply need to tap your Visa, MasterCard or RuPay card on the back of the merchant phone that runs on Paytm for Business app to complete the transaction. This will follow the Reserve Bank of India guidelines for contactless card transaction up to ₹5,000. YouTube for Android prepares to let you set individual videos on loop. Sometimes a YouTube video is good for you and you want to watch it over and over. Unfortunately, there is no easy way to loop an individual video. But that is seemingly changing according to the new string of code in the YouTube app for Android. You can see these changes in the later versions of YouTube. Boat is known for its smartphone accessories and audio products. Now it has launched its new budget smartwatch, the Boat Flash Smartwatch, in India. The Flash Smartwatch has 1.3-inch captive touch LCD round display with an IP68 certified metallic body. It comes with a variety of sensors for health and fitness tracking, such as heart rate sensor and a blood oxygen SpO2 sensor. It also supports 10 active sport mode tracking, such as walking, running, cycling, climbing, yoga, basketball, football, badminton, skipping and swimming. This Flash smartwatch includes an integrated camera with music controls, weather forecast updates and notification alerts. The watch is powered by 200mAh battery that gives up to 7 days and has a standby time up to 20 days. The Boat Flash smartwatch comes in 3 dual band colors. Now it is available on Amazon at an introductory price of ₹2,499. Nothing, the technology company founded by Carl Pei, has reiterated their focus on the designing on their upcoming product launches. Nothing say that the design is the soul of any product, as the first images of the company's first launch have been teased. It is expected that Nothing first launch will be an audio product that could be a wireless earbuds. A cheaper variant Snapdragon 888 processor could be in the works. This chipset may not come with an integrated 5G modem and it could be using 5-nanometer process. Chinese smartphone market is highly competitive one, especially for homegrown brands. For the past few years, Huawei has been in the market leader. However, things have changed ever since. Huawei has faced US sanctions, leading to the company losing access to the most important licensed service like Google Pay services and liberty to use Android for its smartphones. As a result of not being able to deliver the best products due to sanctions, Huawei has lost its crown as the market leader in China for the first time in January 2021. According to the reports, Oppo took a market share of 21%, followed by Vivo, which took 20% of the Chinese smartphone market in the first month of this year, and followed by Huawei, Apple, and Xiaomi tied at the third spot with 16% market share each. Realme 8 series India launch date may be announced officially in 7 to 8 days. It could be around March 25th. The series will be comprised of three models: Realme 8 4G, 8 Pro 4G, and 8 Pro 5G. Realme India CEO Madhav Seth shared an official hands-on video on Realme 8 Pro to reveal its front and rear design. He also mentioned in Twitter that user convenience is our top priority. In the hands-on video, he also mentioned that it could come with in-screen fingerprint scanner and it comes with an AMOLED panel. It had also confirmed that Hansen fronts on 108-megapixel main camera. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.